Everyone, my name is Arne Rekstinš. I come from Latvia and Estonia and from Biodigital Generation 2008. All right, so straight jumping into the action, the research of the parametric tiling takes me to see that in the traditional contemporary world we have all these huge large format materials like sheet metal, we have the marble, granite, some extra big size pieces, but then when we come to standardized items, we end up to the tiles, the ceramic tiles that are square, triangle, hexagon, and whatsoever, and they usually imitate some sort of natural materials. So what I found out is that we can relate to Escher in terms of continuity to find the best pattern that would continue in a never-ending way. So from other side, we do have in the 2020 all those home like artificial intelligence speakers and gadgets that should make our lives better. But if you look at the price, it's like $300 and above. At the same time, we also do have the Arduino that you can buy for like $2. The price here, this is Canadian dollars, 281, so it's $2. And in the context of doing a research, well, I'm also building a house here in Mexico. This is the first zero energy building. And in this stage, when I had already got quite far with the shape and mass, I had like three things that were still not designed, like the actual huge window and the sauna, Finnish sauna, by the way, and also the solar and hybrid wind energy farm on the roof. And I ended up that it has to be something like sauna, of course, because of the Finnish and Estonian traditions. We like it very much. So looking at this space that I had, I also was doing a little homework, making a router, like a router that is 1 meter 20 by 2 meters 40 surface of a three axis router. That is open source project that I built myself from some parts that I bought online, and this is the Maslow CNC open source project. So the sauna starts to get the shape, and I'm figuring out I need the floor, right? So here are the floating shelves, and we get to the point that I'm also teaching in University of Monterrey. And I'm teaching there several subjects, like from design to also some advanced material subjects. And in material subjects, we do touch this field of making the patterns, of repetitive patterns that do have some black and whites from cellular automata inspired designs, and that should have some sort of parametric patterns, and also that they could be treated in all sorts of technology. By the way, University of Monterrey has lots of laboratories for doing this sort of work. Like we made water jet cut stone samples, and then we made some steel samples, we polished them with hand, do some laser engraving, work with the CNC with different varieties of wood. And I figure out that I could also do a mixed technique when we are making molds for casting pieces of concrete, white concrete. And finally, we get to the resins and casting molds that would be very cost effective. Like you only need one mold and you can reproduce it and use it for 100 times. So my students were doing these little samples. Meanwhile, I'm doing the big research I'm showing you in a moment. So then we get to the encrusted pieces. This is like a feature that you fill the engraved part or emptiness with some color tonality. And I came up to this feature that the deeper you cut, you can use the pigment and play around with the tonality. And at some point, well, at the end of semester, we also do play with thermoforming. And finally, when you look at these, like the students have a great portfolio of really interesting samples that are mixed technique obtained pieces that could assemble in a very beautiful interior. So when we put these things aside, my own research takes me a little further. And my own research takes me to the point where I am still needing to make my sauna floor. So long story short, the dimensions were already fixed. So I measured it about 2 meters 60 wide and 1 meter 50 deep. And I tried all sorts of geometries, like starting triangles, squares, rectangles, pentagons, hexagons, etc. But somehow the triangle seemed the most interesting for me. So in terms that it should be wasteless, if you look at this image, you could put in 12 triangles where two of them just have to be cut in half. I ended up that I could get really wasteless design if I do keep to that triangle, but I make a parametric pattern that has the feature that when you rotate it around 120 degrees, you would end up to something like this. Okay, so what do we see here? We have the normal gray concrete that is mixed with regular cement and sand. We do have the black concrete, which is basically the same, but with a black pigment, natural pigment. And we have a white concrete that is using the marble sand and white Cemex cement. So taking these pieces around, obviously I need quite a lot of them, but keeping in mind the zero waste principles, I came up to the need of making a very economic mold. So for making this mold, I would need to cast some pieces 36 times, others also 36 times, and last ones, the middle triangles, just 12 times. So one third of each, so 12, 12, 12, and 12, 12, 12, and 4, 4, 4, each per white, gray, and black pieces, so a totaling of 84. Well, so here is my little plan to make it. The largest ones are actually 57 centimeters long, and I had to calculate it all to inches because my Maslow CNC runs in inches. So the scrap CNC goes in place, I cut out some pieces and these little ones afterwards. Then to make the mold, well, while my students play with little molds, I play with big molds. Look at this video. I made it very short and quick because when you do work with rubber, the silicone has to be cured in within mixed and cast in 2 minutes time. So here's a quick time lapse. And totaling of about 3 kilograms of the material, I ended up with this huge mold and then these little molds. The little ones were filled with resin, epoxic material, and integrated with some encrusted LEDs. Playing around with a lot of tonalities, I end up with some Arduino-like flame effect. The problem with this one is that it shines straight into my eyes, so I do a little adjustment, turning them 90 degrees down, so the LEDs now are shining inside of the piece. Imitating the fire, I end up doing this very beautiful like burning effect that is actually a red light. And the red light is having really beautiful research that the red light wavelength is actually giving you mitochondrial function improvement for the cells, meaning you get a lot of more energy. And also is said that it would help some other skin benefits like damage caused from sunburns. And in Mexico, it would be really actual important thing. And further and further is a huge amount of health benefits that the red light gives to your body, increasing the age-related issues and so on. So here with my little kids, I start casting the concrete, figure out that I need a stronger reinforced cement and some metallic mesh inside, because otherwise it would just break into the parts. So taking it all back and placing it into the sauna design, which is still the work in progress, I'm planning to finish this project pretty soon. And what is the most important, I'm getting to really close results of the zero waste, zero energy, and most important, like a huge amount of health benefits. So there's a little review of the work of mine where it involves the parametrics, the maker's movement, and the zero waste energy and material principle, and also really great health benefits. So next time in Mexico, I welcome you to the very first net zero energy building here in Monterrey, and also to the very first Finnish sauna, I think, in Monterrey in general. So thank you very much, and see you soon.